So I know learning how to control recoil can be really difficult, especially when the advice out there is just pull down the thumbstick or mouse.
Well, no, duh!
And not only that, but the new Caldera base weapons without any attachments have a lot more recoil than the guns we've seen so far in Warzone. So I wanted to share with you today my step-by-step process for mastering recoil on the new Caldera weapons.
House needs to go.
Yikes.
Okay, so some of these weapons aren't even usable, but I promise you, this procedure will help you improve your recoil control either way. For this video, I've chosen to use the Ground Loot Ironsight STG weapon, but I use this same procedure to practice recoil on all the common Ground Loot weapons as well as my loadouts. So the general idea behind recoil control is that I need to move my aiming device in the exact opposite direction as the recoil pattern and at the correct movement rate. So to determine this, I hop into an empty part of the map and I shoot the weapon against the wall until I'm out of bullets. I do not adjust for any recoil at all. I then analyze the bullet holes to look for patterns. I start at the bottom or the first bullet and work my way up. The pattern tells me the direction I need to move my input device over time, and the distance between bullets tells me how far I need to move it. Typically, more distance between bullets means there's more recoil. Now, what I think can be kind of tricky for a lot of people is that the horizontal and vertical recoil patterns often don't stay constant over time as you fire your weapon, especially when you don't have the option to add recoil-reducing attachments like on Ground Loot guns. This means you have to make constant micro adjustments to your aim to compensate for the recoil, and is also why guns like the Kilo are popular to use because the recoil pattern is very simple. So the key to more advanced recoil control is to identify the changes in the bullet hole patterns and connect them to time. And to do that, you need to start counting as you practice your recoil. Now, it's always a good idea to break up complex tasks into smaller pieces, so instead of trying to master the complete recoil pattern, I start by mastering just the first second. I shoot the gun against the wall again and count to 1/1000 without adjusting for recoil. I look at the bullet pattern and then I find a small target to aim at, like this street sign. I then shoot at the sign and move my thumbstick in the opposite direction as the bullet pattern. Because the pattern's all vertical, I just pull down on the right thumbstick. And I test how much to pull down on the thumbstick until I match the rate at which the gun wants to recoil upwards. I keep moving further backwards to make it more difficult, and I repeat until I feel like I've mastered the first second. But above all else, you need to remember to count while you practice. 1/1000. 1/1000. 1/1000. So the rest of the process is pretty simple. I add one additional second and repeat the previous steps until I've mastered the full recoil pattern. 1/1000, 2/1000. So from this, we can see that the recoil pattern starts to go to the right after the first second. So this means we're going to pull straight down for the first second and then pull down into the left for the next second. And then I keep practicing until I've got the pattern down. Now, I could keep going on and on, but I think you get the idea at this point. So now what I recommend you do is pick a day and drop into Plunder over and over again and audition the Ground Loot weapons using this procedure. You should try to find guns that have more predictable recoil patterns and use the previous steps to practice recoil control. These weapons should be the ones you try to find and use during normal battle royale. Now, some of the guns are going to have too much recoil, but what you can do is plan to use them as burst guns. Just practice controlling the first second of recoil. It's better to hit your shots using burst than to miss most of your shots on full auto. Also, be aware that some guns have a lot of visual recoil, but when you look at the actual bullet pattern, there isn't much recoil at all. And because there are so many guns, I recommend taking notes that you can refer back to over time. So that's my procedure for learning recoil control, but if you're still having trouble, there may be one last thing to consider. It's input delay. Input delay is the total amount of time between you pressing a button or moving your mouse to that action being displayed on the screen. Now, input delay is a pretty complicated topic outside of the scope of this video, so just know that you want to keep this value at least below 40 milliseconds or so to avoid sync issues with your game. This is why I recommend using a gaming monitor with a wired connection. If you have questions about input delay, comment below and I'll try my best to answer them. And that's all I have for you today. If you've enjoyed the video, please make sure to give it a like and subscribe to the channel for more content. Thanks, and see you in the next one.